Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to Electronic Campfire number 19. We are at number 19 of, where is it? It's right there. Number 19 of these Electronic Campfires. Welcome. This is the last one for 2022. I almost was not going to do this today. My head is just not into making videos or anything else. It's into constructing and reconstructing and changing around this studio to make it more efficient. I made a video about that this morning, and if you haven't seen that, you might want to check it out. It explains better than I can right now. Anyhow, how are you guys doing? Let's see who's here. Okay. Oh, awesome. We got some backstage folks. Uti, how are you doing? Greetings to Germany. Mr. Jarbel, thank you for the super chat, my friend. That really does help, especially with what I'm doing to this studio. So thank you. I really appreciate it. And who else is here? David from Uruguay. Also, BlueTac318. I know who you are. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Miles, how you doing? Good to see you there. What? Just a lot of backstage. Awesome, awesome. I love interacting with you on Discord, and then I see you here, and it's like, oh, good, the gang's all here. Who else do we have? Danielle from Italy. Buongiorno. Is that how you say it? Welcome, welcome, welcome. So what I thought I would do, first of all, I have no agenda. I have no outline of what I'm going to do. It's going to be very informal. This is probably going to be one of the shorter Electronic Campfires. I just wanted to connect with you for just a little bit before I signed off for the year. And I will not be back possibly as late as January 9th. That would be Monday, January 9th. So it may not go that late. I might be back January 2nd. No promises, though. It's just going to depend on how much I can get done. And I'm going to show you something today. We're actually going to go next door. You're going to come with me. We're going to go next door. And I'm going to show you the one thing that I finished with the studio. That's that, well, almost finished. But it's something I think you'll kind of like. And if you see that, you'll kind of get an idea of where my head is with this change that I want to make. So who else is here? Caitlin, how you doing? Caitlin, yes. Romania, awesome, welcome. Cato from Norway, good to see you. Bobby from San Marcos, Texas, awesome. Awesome, we got lots of people. Lucas, Mr. Wilcall, Tim, how you doing, Tim? We got Gil from Israel, and oh, this is so cool. Portugal, Germany, everybody's here around the world, and I'm just, it just makes my day. I absolutely love it. So, you know, as I said on the video this morning, you know, this is going to be entering the third season for this channel, and I'm not one who thinks that I should change a whole bunch of stuff. I see YouTubers where they'll start out, and there's something really nice about having familiarity. It feels like you're home. You know what I mean? Like this background right here, I love the license plate exactly where it is. I like Hal exactly where Hal is. What my mindset right now in terms of this background and this studio is keep it more or less the same, but clean it up a little bit. If it was a haircut, it would be just do a nice little trim, but don't change the hairstyle. I'm not interested in doing a massive redesign where it's like a completely different room. I'm not up for that, but there are gonna be some changes, and I can give you kind of a preview. Nothing's set yet. I haven't really decided, but what I'm leaning toward right now would be, okay, you notice how in the background you have this black rack right here, okay? I wanna put another one symmetrical on the other side of it. I want to take about half the stuff off and have other things that are on there that are more carefully lit, that are not as cluttered, right? And just so that it's not so busy. And I want to have just a better way of controlling. I have like all these lights are controlled by different switches. I want to have a way to strip it down so I can hit a button, they all come on, and I can just start filming. So that's one idea I have. The other idea, there's a kind of a big Fridays poster that's on this wall over here. In fact, let me see if I can show it to you. Hold on. Let's do this. Let's do this properly. All right. Okay. Do we have any kind of, yay. Okay, cool. Let me know, by the way, because I mean, I didn't rehearse this, so let me know if you run into any problems. Well, how are you going to let me know? I'm going to be in the other room. Well, I apologize in advance if there's any issues of double audio, echoey. I'm going to be switching mics, switching cameras around, doing this live. Well, that's the fun of live. You never know what's going to happen. So, you see this wall right here? Okay. Right there. All right. So, that wall is, I'm going to take everything off of it, and I'm going to cover it with audio panels, like what I have there, okay? Except that it's going to be black. I'm not going to have purple. They were out of purple, so I got black, and it's going to be just kind of a dark... Yeah, we're getting off to a great start. Can you hear me? Test, test. Yeah, I'll tell you something. Yeah, okay. So I'm going to fill it with sound panels, okay, on this wall. Let me make sure this camera doesn't fall off. It's on here. Okay. Sound panels, yes. And then I'm going to have, I'm thinking I've got a VESA mount for a monitor. I might put a monitor there. I'm not sure. And that's sort of where I'm going with it. I want to be able to control the light a little bit better. Because remember that when you light a scene, it's not just the light that is shining on the subject that matters with regard to things like color temperature, but what the light is reflecting off of. And ideal surfaces would be gray or a dark black, that kind of a surface where you can really have some control over the reflection of the light. I want to light this whole area just a little bit better than it's been. So that's kind of where, this is Studio A, you know, this is the main studio. That's where I'm headed with that. And then behind the camera, where, see if I can show you. Okay, this area all back there behind the camera, you see that? I've already started taking stuff down. You see, I don't know if you're familiar with the studio, but look, I've already taken stuff down, okay? And the idea is I really want to clear out a lot of stuff there, and I'm going to move the desk back further. I want to have more space. And the other issue that I have is I have the camera so close to me that I have the teleprompter. So when I'm doing specs and I'm reading specs off, I have to get the specs perfect. So I put it on a teleprompter. The problem with a teleprompter, okay, is that in a teleprompter situation, the closer the teleprompter is to the person who's reading it, the more your eyes are obvious that you are reading a teleprompter. Further back it is, your eyeball has less space to travel, so it doesn't look like you're reading it. So I want to kind of move that back. And I also want to condense the field of view as well. So moving that back, simplifying that background, kind of a black wall on that side with better acoustics so that there's just better sound overall. And then simplifying this background here. That's kind of where I'm going with it. The other idea, and before I tell you that, let me just see who's here. Okay, Merry Christmas to India. How you doing, Russell? Good to see you. Brian, okay. Oh, this is great. Sebastian, good to see you. Yes, it will make... I never have a problem. Here, I gotta put this on the screen, hold on. I never have a problem coming up with a gag reel or a blooper reel. In almost every video I do, I'm either swearing at something, dropping something, fumbling over something, right? I mean, it's just, it's a constant. I mean, just take your pick. Any video I do, I have so much of that stuff. So yeah, I'm gonna put it, I have a folder now called bloopers and screw ups or something like that. I'm gonna put it in there, I always do, and I'll pull it out at the 1 million channel mark if I ever make it that long, 1 million subscribers. So, of course, the Omar Gonzalez label is always going to remain. That, what he's talking about is this right here. If you can see it, hold on. There it is. Okay. So there, yes, that stays on there. And there's a lot of little like Easter eggs in this place, you know, that I don't want to ever get rid of, and I'm not going to get rid of. When my kids were a lot younger, they used to make, they stole my label maker and they used to make me notes and they would stick them all over the place. I've kept all of those up. In fact, here's one right here. There's one. Here's another one. So those I'm absolutely not taking down. So yeah, I'll keep the Omar Gonzalez one up for sure. Oh, wow. Somebody from Norway. Greetings. Greetings, 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 everyone. Robert from Qatar, however it's pronounced. Greetings to you, Sue. All right. Let's take a look now at next door, because I'm actually really proud of this. Now, keep in mind that when I go next door, I'm not going to be able to see your comments. I can't. You could send me $1 million in super chat and I won't know until I get back to my desk, but I won't know over there. So forgive me if I don't respond to you. It's kind of a one-way feed, but let's do this because I have no way of bringing all of this over there yet. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna switch cameras now. I swear I didn't plan this. This Rode mic, I like it. It's the video mic go-to, but I'll tell you something. This is just a statement I have to make. This has really been bugging me. This thing right here, okay? There's something off with this because when I put it on the top of the Sony ZV-1, it's constantly falling, and it shouldn't. This is a vlogging camera. It is supposed to be, you know, thrown around a little bit and waved around. It's a vlogging camera. It shouldn't come off. There we go. Maybe that's better. Okay. Okay, you ready to check it out? Here we go. We're gonna do this. Okay, 3, 2, 1, and I've got to switch the audio. Okay, we're here. Now, I'm going to turn off this audio. Turn on this audio. Test, test, test. Test, test. Okay, can you see me, I hope? All right, so let's go. I don't have a very long cord, but I'll do the best I can. Okay, so right now, for those of you that are used to the studio, if you can see how much stuff is already gone, look at that. Remember all the stacks of stuff that was there? It's all gone now. I've moved it into here. Okay, so look at this. Have a look at this. This is the brand new battery charging station that I just put together. I've been working on it for about 4 days. I love it. And everything that you see that I use to put it together, I either got on Amazon or Target. It's not expensive at all to do this. Couple little tricks that I'll show you. Now this cord is not gonna reach, so let me zoom in. Hold on. Okay, focus. Okay, there we go. So look at that, you see I've got, you know what? Let me do this. Nothing like a tripod. Okay. Okay. I used a tripod. Okay, so now I can kind of explain to you. I can't move the camera any closer because my HDMI cable won't reach. And I know the minute I try and make it reach, it's going to pop out and I'll lose the signal. So this is as close as I can get it. But if you have a look at this, okay? So they're all labeled. And what I used was this little brother label maker right here, okay? This is probably the most expensive, you know, material used to build this thing. But basically, this is pegboard. And my wife had the idea of using Velcro because this is concrete wall behind me. And so I'm not about to be putting holes through it. I just didn't want to do that. So I used Velcro and I put it on a kind of a particle board thing. And then I put that on here. So I have like a pegboard here that has these battery little containers coming out. And if you're interested, let me know in the comments and I will link these items, exactly the same items I used. I'll link them down in the description below if this is something you'd want to add to your studio perhaps. But basically all the batteries are here, charging areas right here, and I put them vertically, okay? So for example, if I want to charge an Insta360 battery, I can just boom, you know, and they stay right in perfectly. They don't, you know, they don't fall out or anything. It's great. Fuji, same thing, goes right in, just like that, real easy. Let me zoom in, hold on. Sony ZV-1, there it is. And so now these are upside down. These are upside down. I've been getting a lot of comments about that. I posted a picture of this. They're upside down on purpose. There is a reason they're upside down. Okay, these Fuji chargers. And that reason, let me see if I can turn it so you can see it. Okay, the reason they're upside down is because these cords jut straight up, okay? And if I had them right side up, they would jut down here and block my hand getting to this. So yeah, the Fujifilm brand name is upside down, but it's more functional. And that's the idea here. Everything is functional, okay? So moving on, we have this. I got these at Target. There it is. Okay, I got all of these at Target. They come in bins of three. They're like, you know, little bins of three. You stack them, they're little drawers. And these are perfect because you can put camera mounts in here. You can put, and what I do is when I get something, like let's say I get the Insta360 X3. Anytime you buy any kind of gear, whether it's camera or whether it's, you know, a lens or anything at all, it comes with like instructions and clamp and a couple of charging cords. So I always keep everything together in its own drawer. So immediately I can get to it. So I don't have these yet organized, but just as an example of the stuff that I would have in here would be like lightning cables, has its own drawer, right? All that Apple stuff. And I have the same kind of thing. I don't know if you can see it, but down here I have three. Okay, have a look at this right here. This is bent. Okay, so I've identified three technical problems so far, okay? Whoever's still watching it right now, thank you, because this couldn't have gone any worse. I believe we lost picture for quite a while, because as I was holding the camera, this stupid micro HDMI bent, and I think you lost picture. I'm not 100%, but I think you've lost picture. No audio. The audio's back, folks. The audio's back. I know it's back because I just hit that button. And that's another thing. I had to switch audio sources because the audio was picking up through here and the boom mic. So I cut the one on the camera just now and put the boom mic back. So, all right, that was a total disaster. I don't know if you saw anything there, but I promise you this. Come January, you're gonna get a full-blown behind-the-scenes tour. It'll be a video, it'll be really awesome, and I will go through everything that I did, the mindset behind it, why I did it that way. And so, consider this just a complete failure, okay? Which just adds to the whole point of, I have reached max, I'm at burnout right now. I'm right there. I'm right at that ceiling. Okay. I can't go any higher. I'm right there. So, but hopefully you saw something. I don't know. But do you all, I mean, I hope this is a teaching moment. Fuji, if you're watching this, okay, knock off the micro HDMI cables. I just stop with these things. Okay. I know I used a Sony ZV-1, but I was going to use a Fuji cam, but I hate these things. I don't care if Sony uses them. I don't want Fuji using them. Just put the regular, look at this thing. It's just this tiny little thing bent. You see that? And that caused the signal to drop and you lost it. So, oh well. The other thing I'm thinking about doing is maybe having one of these in the background. I love this light. Maybe not so bright, but I love it. And I want to somehow incorporate it somewhere. So that's kind of, I'm just kicking around ideas. So now it's your turn, okay? I would love your ideas. I couldn't show you everything, and I don't even know if you saw the battery stuff next door, but any ideas you have, I would love to hear them. Let me know in the comments, because I haven't started anything yet. I'm going to be doing it starting tonight. And I'm taking a day off tomorrow and Sunday, but next week, I'm going to be full in. I'm taking everything out of here. And so if you have any ideas that, you know, you think, oh, I saw a great YouTuber where blah, 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 blah. I'd love to hear it. I would love to hear it. Okay, so let me get back to this. We have some super chats. I wanna say thank you too. I can't see this stuff so far away. Okay. I cannot pronounce your name. I am so sorry. It is in another language, I believe from China. So thank you so much for the super chat. If there's any way you could comment back and write an English sounding version of it, I would be happy to read it out. But thank you, okay, for the super chat there. Is it Ketil? Ketil Holland, thank you for the super chat. Eric, I really appreciate it. I think I know who you are. Yes. Thank you so much. This really helps. I'll tell you right now, you want to know where your money just went for the super chat? Replacing this cord. I use this thing all the time. I'm constantly plugging it into the Fuji cam, which goes into the monitor. And that's, you know, when you see me and I'm going, well, you go into your settings menu, into the wrench, and then da 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 da. That's what I'm using this broken cord for. So I have to buy another one of these. So today's super chat, you just paid for it. Thank you. You have just supported the channel. Happy holidays. That's great. Thank you. Okay, let's get back to the chat. To everybody, Natalie, how you do? Wireless HDMI, that is another idea I probably should have pursued this week in planning this live stream, but there was no plan for this live stream at all. Normally I plan out the live streams, I write it out. I actually come in and I rehearse my live streams. I go through what I'm gonna show and how I'm gonna do it. As you can see, none of that happened today. Scott from Toronto, how you doing? Oh, that's Australia, Toronto. Good to see you. Good to see you. What is a super chat? Somebody asked, what is a super chat? Super chat is this thing, and it always feels weird to me, okay? I mean, I really appreciate them. Don't get me wrong. I am not complaining. But it is a way for viewers to support the channel, and that's awesome. I love all that part about it, which they can... It's like adding a tip, you know, it's giving a little bit of a financial contribution to the channel. And what they get out of it is that it highlights the fact they did that and it puts it kind of at the top of the comments. What's a little stressful for me is sometimes I miss them. You know, I don't necessarily see them all and I feel horrible if I miss any. So that's the only thing, but And I just saw one come in. So thank you, BlueTech 318. Thank you. James, how you doing? Vishal, bringing back the Stormtrooper. I don't know. Let me put this up on the monitor. I don't have the space to put the Stormtrooper in here. I love the Stormtrooper. I mean, my wife made it, but I don't have, where am I gonna put it? Maybe I could put it in that corner over there. It's possible. And part of the problem, oh, I wish I could show you. Let me see if I could get this stupid thing working again. Yes, I did call the ZV-1 with the micro HDMI stupid. One of the things that, yeah, it's a goner. this cable is no more. Definitely no more. Oh, darn it. That's a shame. So do I have a Fuji cam? Let me see if I got a Fuji cam laying around. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Anybody recognize this? You know the problem? Micro HDMI. No, never mind. Just use your imagination. That corner in that studio, just past the Gear Iguana Hall of Fame sign, maybe I could put the Stormtrooper there. Of course, it wouldn't be on camera. But it's huge. I mean, it would be so massively large behind me, and I think that it would be, it's almost too much, you know, as much as I love it. Maybe it could be something that goes out there or something that I could feature from time to time. I could roll it in, but as a permanent part of the studio, probably not. Probably not. And I know you're kidding. Okay, so hello, Paul. Good to meet you. Savannah, Georgia is gorgeous. Love Savannah. There we go. I want you all to entice him in the comments. Of course you want to switch to Fuji. Of course. We're a crazy Fuji fam here. Hello to Istanbul, Turkey. Yes, Brendan is so right. It is beyond annoying. Okay, am I missing? Let's see here. Thank you so much, Paul, for the super chat. I really appreciate it. Okay, oh, wow. Hey, I love getting comments like this. I would love it even more if I was in Iceland, but this is awesome. Thank you for letting me know. I really appreciate it. That's awesome. No. Murat, thank you, by the way, but it's not January 19th. It's January 9th. The 9th of January. So not the 19th, that would be too long. Okay, so won't be that long. This is good, it's not a bad idea. A very large TV vertically for information. Yeah, you know, who is a channel that constantly uses those monitors? It's Tony and Chelsea Northrup. I always see Tony has one of those monitors and he uses it almost as a PowerPoint, you know? And I had actually done that for my first few live streams. I actually wheeled it in and did that. The problem I had was it wasn't bright enough and you couldn't see the screen very well for PowerPoint. And so I don't know, maybe. I do have a monitor that I could use and I could rotate it vertically. So that is a good idea for sure. I don't know, Miles. It either gets brought down to me or it doesn't. I don't know. I know I don't have any control over that area. I can't even get the Sony ZV-1 to work today, let alone. Maybe if I had a few of those, maybe I could get it to work. Matt Irwin has a TV as well. Okay. So, yeah, that's not bad, you know. And I do have hold on a second. I do have a larger TV now that I think about it. So something like this, right? Like this, do it. And look, I got the same stickers I was telling you about here and here. You know what this one says? I just have to say, I don't know if you can see it. Actually, let me switch to this other. If I drop this, I'm just gonna cut to black and start drinking heavily, okay? All right, so have a look here. I don't know if you can see it. I don't know if you could see that, but it said, Daddy, please spend time with us. because I was spending a lot of time, you know, setting up the studio. And so they came in, they printed that label out, and they stuck it on this. I love that stuff. I love it. So, all right. So I may put this up behind me. I don't know. This thing's really heavy, too. So I don't know if it's gonna go. Anyway. Oh, thank you, Sebastian. It is chaotic, is the word for today's live stream. By far the most chaotic live stream I've done. wait a second. All right, let's all get on them about it. Dimitri, what's the matter with you? Do your homework. Do your homework. I'll give you this pass now, but I expect your homework done by the time I get to Flash tutorial number 4, which you have until about the third week of January, when that one's coming out. So there you go. That's right. I don't need a teleprompt. Good, 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 good. Excellent. So how's everybody doing? What are your plans for the holidays? Or do you have any plans? Just kind of stay home, stay away from crap. You couldn't pay me to go to an airport right now. Not any amount of money to go to an airport right now. But if you are flying, if you are traveling, fly safe, travel safe, and don't, you know, don't get too crazy with the holiday last minute rush. You know, something that, oh, hold on a sec. We got a super, hold on. Let me do this properly. Yay. Hooray. Okay. So we got a super chat from Michelle White. Thank you, Michelle. I really appreciate it. See, I'm getting better at the super chat thing now that I kind of can see it. So I was in Target the other day and I walked by the toy aisle. You know, where they have the action figures and they have the little dolls and they have all the toys. Now, I don't know if there's any new dads out there watching this, but if there are, listen to what I'm saying right now. It goes by really fast. So as I walk through this toy aisle area, I realized that there was really nothing there that I could box up and get for my kids because they're a little bit past that now. For them, it's all about, you know, a Steam gift card for the latest online game or, you know, some cool app or something like that. You know, but the days of kind of racing to get toys, I know it can be stressful to new dads out there. I know the holiday season's stressful. It's crazy, but try and enjoy it because I promise you it will be gone one day and it'll be a lot sooner than you think. So that was a little realization I had a couple of days ago, and I just thought I'd share it with you. So we got, okay, so Mr. Jarble is going to avoid the traffic and the storm. Good, good. And, okay. Well, let's see. I can't, it's hard for me to do that, and I'll tell you why. I haven't opened the box. Honestly, so box unopened are my two words. I know it seems crazy to you that I haven't opened that out and tested that lens out. And I even had Viltrox write to me earlier today. I'm sorry, Viltrox, if you're watching, I have not responded. They want to know what I think of it. Well, you know, they're curious. And I have just been so consumed with the redesign of the studio. I had to make this morning's video for you. I'm going to be testing that lens out Sunday, most of the day Sunday, shooting family stuff with it, and I will let you know, I promise. Viltrox is going to be one of the very first videos you see from me when I return. It'll be the 75mm review. I just couldn't get to it before then. Lens reviews take me longer than normal videos to do, mostly because there's a lot of testing that I have to test and then retest and then retest again. So yeah, that's going to be coming in January. So those are my two words. In box, still in box, that's three words. Not unboxed is the two words. All right. Yeah, you were on, this is live, Ali. Yes, this is a live session. trust me, I'm not this chaotic and goofy and screwing things up. Well, I am, but you don't see it because I edit it out. Okay, I cut it out. So yes, this is called a live stream. This is live, and a lot of people get nervous, including myself, doing it live because it's live. I mean, you know, there you have people like me who like to be in control of every little thing, you know, with editing, with thumbnail creation, with, you know, which shot should I use? Wait a minute, that one's emphasizing my hair. I got to do this and cut. To do it live, you have to give up control and you have to be prepared for screw ups and you have to roll with it. You know, I was really excited to show you that battery charging panel station thing that I put together. I was more excited about that than on a lot of things. And it totally blew up. But that's okay. We just roll with it and it's going to make a really great video. To do all future live chats like this one. Okay, so Sebastian, what when you say like this one, how else would I do it? Like, in other words, have no agenda at all, don't script it out, and just sit down and we'll see what happens. Or, and this is a good question for the rest of you. With these live streams, because I plan on doing it, we're going to do Electronic Campfire number 20 when I get back. Do you like the more informal format where I don't know what I'm going to talk about, I'll just go off here? Or would you like it a bit more scripted and rehearsed and, you know, not screwing up as much? Let me know what you think in the comments. And Miles, thank you for the super chat. I'm now holding up this thing so I can't see. And that's another thing. I got to talk to you about my glasses. Awesome. Fireside Nut Brown. Okay, Miles, I got to go pick that up. If there's any Fireside Nut Brown upstairs, maybe we can have a little bit. I don't know. Maybe. Sometimes they watch my live stream. Sometimes they don't. We'll find out if anybody comes down here. Yeah, I'm going to probably get a different pair of glasses because I'm going to move the monitor further away, so I might have a slightly different look there. I thought about just going contacts only, but no, I'm going to stay with the glasses, I think. And yeah, you know. Okay, so, oh, here we go. So what movies am I going to watch during the break? Hateful Eight and Die Hard 2. I don't know about Die Hard 2. Die Hard for sure. Die Hard 2 wasn't quite as good. If you haven't seen it, see it. But I don't know about rewatching Die Hard 2. Hateful Eight is great. It's not Quentin Tarantino's best film, but it's certainly, if you haven't seen it and you like Quentin Tarantino, you will like it. We saw Avatar: Way of Water. It took me a little bit of time to get used to that frame rate going back and forth because it would shift from 48 frames per second, you know, to 24 and then back. And I mean, I noticed it. I don't know if anybody else did. And it was just a little jarring for me. Movie was great. It's fun to be able to go into a theater and just be so immersed. And yeah, the story is simple. You know, it's a simple story, very simple. But I think that was the whole idea. Because when you're making a movie that is going to cost that much money, and it needs to do that well around the world, it's got to be a drop-dead, simple, common theme that most all cultures can identify with. So I think that's why they went with it and didn't make it overly complicated. Was it James Cameron's best movie? No, not at all. You know, was it as good as Terminator 2? No, I don't think so. But it's still worth going to see in a theater if you like to see movies in a theater, because there's only so much streaming and having a little screen in your living room. Seeing it in a theater, just there's something about that that is incredible. And my whole family, we all went together, and that was so much fun to be able to see it with my kids and my wife and just have that shared moment to enjoy it. So yeah, that was great. Love that. And so, yeah, there is one thing. It is a 3-hour and 10-minute. Well, here's the thing about it. It's a 3-hour and 10-minute movie, but some theaters are showing trailers and ads. So you're looking at a 3.5-hour sit time, just so you know. Can you get up and use the restroom halfway through? Absolutely, you can. If you do it during the first hour, you won't miss any real critical plot points. You don't want to get up during the last hour. Okay, so do what you got to do, but you don't want to get up during that last hour for sure. What else? Good Christmas movies. I hate to say it, but Eyes Wide Shut is, that's the last movie anybody thinks of as a Christmas movie. But oh my gosh, the cinematography in there with the Christmas lights in almost every single shot and just that feeling of recreating New York, which Kubrick did in London, was amazing. I do consider that a Christmas movie, as crazy as I am. Love Actually, that's always a wonderful film. It's sweet. I love that movie. And Die Hard, another great Christmas movie. Right. Natalie, I don't know. Okay, now that's two people who've liked the second one better. So maybe I need to give it another watch. I saw it once when it came out. I saw it in the theater long time ago. And I just remember it was about Dulles Airport. And I have more horrors at Dulles Airport when I'm at Dulles Airport than I did in the movie. But, you know, maybe it's worth a second watch. I'll give it a second watch. I will watch it with my son. He loves Die Hard. So we'll watch that. And I will report back to you on that one. All right. Yeah, Alan Rickman wasn't in it. And that was another problem I had with it. Okay, Baker, Fabulous Baker Boys, there you go. That's another good one. I like that. That's another good one. Hello, hello to Naples. Hello, hello. What do I use as a teleprompter? That's a good question. We have dead air, folks, dead air. Glide gear. Okay, so I've gone through a number of teleprompters and I finally settled on one that was large enough for me because I needed the text to be really big. And it's called Glide Gear Pro. Glide Gear Pro. And you know what I should do is put a kit up for 2023 of the studio gear that I use. Because on one hand, hey, if I can make a few bucks on those affiliate links, why not? But on the other hand, I do get a lot of questions and it would be nice to have like themed little sections of, this is all my studio gear for YouTube videos. This is all my photography gear for outdoor portraits. This is all my blah, 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 and my blah, blah, blah. These are the lenses I recommend for da, 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 and have these like little themed packets. You know, I think that might help, especially newbies to Fujifilm Cam. Okay, where are we at on time? All right, we got about another 5 or 6 more minutes before I'm gonna shut it down. Hello, hello, John. So, listen, I didn't get a chance to say this, and I was actually gonna make a separate video for the Backstage. Well, I did already on Coffee Time, but I was gonna make another one for Backstage and then another one for channel members. And I thought, I'm making all these different videos and I'm basically saying the same thing. So I'm gonna say it now. And that is, thank you for being here with me this year and for being a part of this channel and for just, how can I put it? Being you. You know, your comments are you. You know, your sense of humor. I cannot tell you how many times I bust out laughing when I read the comments to my videos or when I'm interacting back and forth with you or through email and messages and IM and all that stuff. And that has been just, I can't say it's been the highest point of the year because it's been constant throughout the whole year, but it's elevated the year. It's like it's pumped up the whole year by having that, by having you in my life like that. I mean, we're not family, you know, you don't know me from Adam other than what you see in these videos and the fact that I can't make an HDMI micro 2 cable work. But I do think we have a connection to this channel and I hope that you feel that way. I know I feel that way. Even though right now I'm talking to a piece of glass, don't know if you can hear me, but I'm talking to a piece of glass. But if you can hear me, know that you do really, really make a difference with this channel. And I'm really excited about 2023. So I wanted to say that. Happy holidays. Happy New Year. Be safe. Okay? No drinking and driving, as you should, your Uncle Pal detect. And that's another thing. My audience demographic is a lot younger than me. And that kind of tripped me out. You know, I was going through YouTube. My average viewer for this channel is between the ages of 25 and 35 male. Not too many females, mostly men, but mostly in that age bracket, okay? I'm 55. So I think from here on out, I got to be referred to as your Uncle Pal to Tech. Okay, so your Uncle Pal to Tech is saying, don't drink and drive, have a wonderful holiday, and above all else, thank you so much for being here and being a part of this channel. Okay, now, do I have any more? Okay, we're good on that. 44 in a few days. Okay, that's a yes, it is. Oh boy, we got birthdays coming in. We got lots. I'm gonna put everybody's birthdays on the screen. Everybody's birthday, hooray! This is great. We're all in that piece. Oh, thank you, Vishal. Thank you. Well, I'm not going to ask you how old you are, Michelle, but if you're skewing the average, okay. Percent, how much does it contribute to your income? It's not yet enough for me to do it full time. That's what I'll say at this point. Ideally, I would like it to be that, but right now, no. The problem, and it hasn't really gotten to a point where I can say it's this percentage or that percentage because it fluctuates so much. It's, 5 months out of the year, it's just beer money. I mean, barely beer money. And then, for example, last month, it was probably 30 or 40%, okay, because it just did really well. I had a lot of affiliate link clicks and I did a couple of sponsored things, and so it was kind of a hurry up and get all that done, and I foresee it probably slowing down in January, which I'm going to be doing the opposite. I'm going to be speeding up and doing a lot of production in January. So, I'm not yet ready to go full-time, but let me tell you this. The microsecond, the microsecond I can do this full-time, and nothing else, I'm there. I'm doing it. Absolutely, 100%. I'm locked in. That's what I want. I love doing this stuff. And what I love the most is not the YouTube thing. I don't actually like the direction YouTube's going. I hate vertical video. I don't like those repeat, 60-second thing. I don't like the direction they're going right now. I think they're making mistakes. But what I love is education. I love teaching more than anything. So YouTube is sort of a teaching delivery device for me, okay? If I was a smoker, it would be like a cigarette. That's a nicotine delivery device, or a Pez, that's a candy delivery device, okay? YouTube is an education delivery device that I can use to do what I really love, which is teach stuff, ISO or, the exposure triangle or whatever. I love that. That's my favorite part of the whole YouTube behind the scenes thing is teaching. So I'm going to be getting back to that more. Season 3 of Pal to Tech is going to dive more into education. Still going to do gear reviews, but after probably January, because I still have a bunch of them that are backed up from this year. But as we get into February and especially March, gear reviews are going to take a kind of a back seat to the education stuff, where I am more focused on consistent flash tutorials, consistent Capture One tutorials, consistent, and the biggest problem that I am having, and I really need your help. I don't know how to solve this. I'm at a loss. I really need your help. And here's what it is. A lot of you have been with this channel since the beginning, which I love. I love that. Okay. But the problem is that you all are not in the same place you were in the beginning. You've learned a lot. You've grown. You are completely different now in terms of your photography skill, where you are in your career with that, or your hobby, or whatever it is. You are in a different place. And so, for example, you may now already know about focus stacking, right? But there's a whole group of people still out there that don't understand what focus stacking is, or the exposure triangle, or auto ISO, right? All that stuff. And so I have this need inside me to continue teaching those topics, even though this group of which you are a part of has kind of grown past that. So I don't know how to solve this, but I don't want to lose the college graduates, okay? Because I'm teaching grammar school. Does that make sense? If you can help me solve that, that'd be the greatest holiday gift I could get.
It is no holiday gift.
Oh, look at this.
It's the holiday beer.
It's the holiday beer. Look at my beautiful wife. Look at her.
Bright light.
We are going to do a video. I'm going to announce it now. Come here. We're going to do a video. There, if you can see yourself there, you're live. So we're going to do a video. You may not know this, and as I haven't talked about it, my wife is building a robot. No joke. I'm talking welding steel. Now, if you saw my XH2 review a while back, I shot it where she was welding. So I have video proof of this, but she's building Wally, the movie Wally. Okay, that little Wally robot. How much is it going to weigh?
About 250 pounds.
200. She's building a 250-pound piece of steel remote, the full Wally. I mean, everything about it. Yeah. Exactly screen accurate. How long have you been working on it?
Over a year.
You should see this thing. It's insanity. So I'm going to do one of the videos. Remember I talked about the videos I like to do versus the ones that kind of get the ratings for the channel. The one I like to do is a little mini behind the scenes of this incredible thing you've been working on.
So you're going to make a video of that?
I'm going to make a video. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. We're going to do a video on it. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, I'll bring the camera in and some lights.
I better slow down my work, as if I could work any slower.
Yeah.
The studio looks good.
What, are you nuts?
No. You've cleaned up. I can see already. You guys can't see, but I can see, and it already feels cleaner in here.
They can't see because I tried taking them next door. Look at what happened to this thing. So I broke another cord.
You could ask Santa.
Yeah, well, I got super chats. In fact, Peter just sent a super chat. Thank you, Peter.
Thank you very much. I can't see any of that because I have crappy eyes like you.
I can't see it either.
I see like a blur,
like a yellow blur, right?
It's like a blob. Oh, that's yeah. Cool. I can't see any. I just see colors.
All right.
I'm going to get
good.
Back upstairs.
We're good. Okay.
Love you. Happy holidays, everyone.
All right. Thank you so much for the beer. We're going to do a toast here. Love you. What is she nuts? The studio looks terrible. There's stuff thrown all over the place, but I get her point. It's getting simplified, definitely. But wait, I have in my head what it's going to look like at the end. Oh, I can't wait to show it to you. All right, so we got to do, that's great. Send me a photo, send it to that email address on YouTube. I want to see your pictures. So before she came down here, I just want to button this up by saying that is something that this year I do want to get back to, because I know I've done videos on auto ISO, but you know, maybe it's time to do another video on auto ISO with the X-T5. And that may bore a number of you because you know auto ISO already. So that's the challenge I'm running into. And I think any teacher or any educator, if they were teaching, say, an 11th grade class, that they would be foolish the next year to then start teaching college stuff because that class has moved on. And what about all the people behind them that don't know those topics? You know, so that's something that I've taken a real hard look at this channel. And I think there's a lot of screw ups I've made and there's a lot of things that I don't do well, but there are a couple of things I think I do really well. And I think high up on that short list is, I think I am very good at explaining a complicated topic in a simple way at a pace that can be understood by international audiences where English is, say, a second language, or people who aren't familiar with photography or filmmaking terms. So I feel like in some ways that was what I was meant to do, you know? And so as much as I want to grow with you, as much as I want us to kind of go to the next level, you know, oh, we don't need focus stacking anymore. Now we need to do this. Part of me wants to still get excited about it and do more of that for all the new wide-eyed students. You know, I don't know if I'm making any sense, but that is the number one thing I don't know how to solve, or if I should solve it, or if I just divide it up half and half and every Friday is beginner Friday. You know, I don't know. I don't know. So if you have any thoughts on that, that would be a big help. In the meantime, I'm going to be signing off for this year. This is the last you're going to see of me this year. If you have a glass, please raise it. We're going to do a worldwide toast, something only possible in the last few years because with live streaming, can you imagine, you know, like Benjamin Franklin doing a toast around the world? It'd be impossible. We're going to do it. We're doing it right now. So raise your glass. I'm going to say, hold on, got Peters, yes, thank you. Okay, we're all good here. Oh, great, great, great advice coming in. Thank you. This is really helpful. Wow, okay. Yeah, I'm gonna read all these later, okay? But what we're going to do right now is okay, so here's a good question. I gotta answer this. So there is a YouTube library, but as I make more videos, two things happen. One, they get harder to find. YouTube doesn't have a very good way of getting really old videos to the forefront. And sometimes they just get lost in the shuffle. People don't find them. The other problem has to do with, obviously, with camera models. And I know that the same topic, you know, what is ISO, for example, can apply to any camera. But when you say, what is ISO with an X-T5? You know, that hits anybody that has an X-T5 is going to a little bit more motivated to learn because you've now dropped it right into their lap. So there's a sense of relevance about doing updated versions of the same topic, but with newer cameras. But good point, though. I mean, I do have videos, and obviously I am probably never going to do another what is ISO video again. I think that video that I did, if you haven't seen it, check it out. It's called what is ISO, I think. If you go to my channel and you search ISO, you'll see it. But that video is exactly, in my opinion, perfect. So I don't see any reason to redo that. Videos that I'd want to redo would be things like focus stacking or, you know, lighting tips, stuff like that, audio, things that change over time. And sometimes I learn things. I learn new ways of doing things. So I want to incorporate that as well. And the technology changes. Okay, so we are all waiting here for this thing. This thing just auto shut off and it was laying on it. It went, the lens kind of went in. I was like, ah, what is that? Okay, here we go, folks. This is to 2023. I wish all of you the best. Thank you for being here. Cheers to you. This is to you. All right. Cheers, everyone. This is awesome. Okay. Oh, yeah, this is delayed because somebody just wrote, I have my class up, hurry up. Right. It must be delayed by about, you know, at least 2 minutes. That's okay. Diet Coke works fine. That's just fine. All right, everyone. Thank you so much for putting up with the technical glitches today. If you are just joining us, roll this video back to the beginning and you'll see what I mean. We're going to go through the new studio next year. I will be back January 9th at the latest, Monday, January 9th. If you like this live stream, by all means, feel free to give it the like and subscribe. Have a wonderful Christmas and a wonderful New Year's, wonderful holidays to all of you. Best wishes. And as always, let me get my music ready. I always miss that. Okay. Is there anything else I want to say? Wow. You're not going to see me till next year. I will see you next year. And I know it seems redundant, but I'm just going to say it one more time. Thank you. Thank you. I'll see you next year, everyone. Take care.